السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. كتاب الوضوء. We're continuing with صحيح البخاري. And today we're going to talk about the chapter of Wudu, كتاب الوضوء. First, Imam al-Bukhari started this chapter with the ayah that is mentioned in the Quran about the description of Wudu, how Wudu is made. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, إِذَا قُمْتُمْ إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ فَاغْسِلُوا وُجُوهَكُمْ. When you come to the prayer, wash your faces, وَأَيْدِيَكُمْ إِلَى الْمَرَافِقِ, and your hands all the way to the elbows, وَامْسَحُوا بِرُؤُوسِكُمْ وَأَرْجُلَكُمْ إِلَى الْكَعْبَيْنِ, and wipe your heads and wash your feet all the way to the ankles. Of course, he mentioned the ayah, and then he said, وَبَيَّنَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, the Prophet صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ explained, أَنَّ فَرْضَ الْوُضُوءِ مَرَّةً مَرَّةً, that the obligatory thing in wudu is just to wash, to wipe every part of these parts just one time. وَتَوَضَّ أَيْضًا مَرَّتَيْنِ. However, the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ sometimes wash each part of these parts two times. وَثَلَاثًا, and sometimes three times. وَلَمْ يَزِدْ عَلَى ثَلَاثًا, and he did not increase it more than three times. So the sunnah is to wash every part of these, the parts of wudu, three times as mentioned. وَكَرِهَ أَهْلُ الْعِلْمِ الْإِسْرَافُ فِيهِ وَأَنْ يُجَاوِزُوا فِعْلَ النَّبِيِّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. The scholars said it is disliked to do more than three times. And we're going to come to the one hadith that says that this is tajawuz, transgression, as the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said, inshallah. باب لا تقبل صلاة بغير طهور. The salah is not going to be accepted without ablution or without being cleaning yourself by making wudu. The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم says, as Abu Huraira narrating here, لا تقبل صلاة من أحدث حتى يتوضأ. The salah of the person who makes hadith is not accepted until he makes wudu. قال رجل من حضرموت, a man from حضرموت in Yemen said, ما الحدث, what do you mean حدث بروفد, يا أبا هريرة. He said, فساء أو ضراد. حدث is to break your wudu by passing gas or by farting. So this is a حدث. So anybody loses his wudu, he must make a fresh and new wudu. باب فضل الوضوء. The following chapter is talking about the excellence of wudu, why wudu is so important. The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم says, as mentioned here in this hadith, إِنَّ أُمَّتِي يُدْعَوْنَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, my ummah will come on the day of judgment, غُرًّا مُحَجَّلِينَ. غُرًّا means that they have some mark of light on the forehead. غُرًّا مُحَجَّلِينَ. So the ummah of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم will come in this way, marked by shining foreheads, من آثار الوضوء, because of the wudu. فمن استطاع منكم أن يطيل غرته فليفعل. Whoever can make this shining trace bigger, let him do by washing like the forehead all the way up to the last, you know, part. But some narrators, some scholars of hadith say that this last part is added by Abu Huraira, that the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said that the ummah will come this way from the wudu, but Abu Huraira said whoever can do more by performing wudu, let him do that. They say that this addition is from Abu Huraira. باب لا يتوضأ من الشك حتى يستيقن. If somebody has doubt that he lost his wudu or not, but he does not have something to confirm that, he shouldn't break his salah to make wudu. The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم explained that. عن عباد بن تميم عن عمه أنه شكى إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الرجل الذي يخيل إليه أنه يجد الشيء في الصلاة, فقال لا ينفتل أو لا ينصرف حتى يسمع صوتا أو يجد ريحا. A man complained to the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, said that sometimes we have doubts that we lost our wudu, like little gas passed, but just a doubt. They're not sure about that. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, do not leave your salah until you are certain by hearing a voice, like a voice of a fart, or you are certain that, you know, that you lost your wudu because you smell a bad smell. But if you just have doubts, that's not the thing. But let us suppose that somebody passed gas without smelling anything or hearing any fart, but he knows that he passed gas and he's sure about that, he must break his salah, of course, and make a new and fresh wudu if this is the case. But it just, you know, if somebody just has doubts and it's not proved and it always comes to him, he should continue his salah normal, and his salah, his wudu is correct. Bab at-takhfif fil wudu. This chapter is to perform light wudu. عن ابن عباس أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم نام حتى نفخ ثم صلى وربما قال اضطجع حتى نفخ ثم قام فصلى. That's one thing. They say that the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم sometimes he might, you know, fall asleep while he's sitting, and then you hear a little snoring, and then he wakes up and then goes to the prayer. Or sometimes he lays down and then he gets up in the night and then he gets up to the prayer. I would say that, let's explain one thing about that. If the person, because this happens to the Sahaba sometimes, but this is the case. If the person is sitting and he's so sure that he's sitting in the right way, like he's so sure that he's sitting in the right way and nothing comes out of him in terms of passing gas or farting, because he is sealing the place where the farting comes out. So even if he goes to sleep and he snores and he takes a little nap, because the Sahaba sometimes they were sitting good in a straight way and then they go to deep sleep and then they wake up for the Salah time in the Masjid and they pray, they don't have to make a fresh wudu. However, if the person is laying down or sleeping and he goes to deep sleep, then he must perform wudu, as we're going to explain later, because the Prophet ﷺ says, "Al-Ainu wika'u as-sahl." The eye is a seal of the area where the passing gas comes out. So this area you have control over it as long as your eyes open and you're awake. But if you go to deep sleep and you're sleeping, so you have no control on that. We're going to explain that, inshallah. That's part of the fiqh like Islamic fiqh, details of the worships, as we say. We're going to explain that on time, inshallah. So Ibn Abbas said, "Qala bittu 'inda khalati Maymuna." I slept over at the house of my aunt, my maternal aunt, his aunt from his mother's side, Maymuna, Layla. فقام النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. This is the wife of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said that the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم stood up. فقام من الليل at night time. فلما كان في بعض الليل قام النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فتوضأ. The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم woke up and made wudu من شن معلق وضوءا خفيفا. He made a quick wudu from a bag of water. يخففه عمر ويقلله. It's very very light. وقام يصلي فتوضأت نحوا مما توضأ. When I saw him wake up and he made wudu, so and he started the prayer at night prayer, and then I woke up myself and then I made a quick wudu like him, and then I started to go for salah. ثم جئت فقمت عن يساري. I stand on the left side. فحولني فجعلني عن يميني. Then he switched me to the right side with his hand during the salah. ثم صلى ما شاء الله. Then he prayed what Allah wished that he prays. ثم اضطجع. Then he went to sleep again. فنام حتى نفخ. He went to sleep until I can hear him snoring. ثم أتاه المنادي. Then he hear the caller of the prayer telling him that now salah for fajr. فقام معه إلى الصلاة فصلى ولم يتوضأ. He went to the salah and he did not make wudu. قلنا لعمر إن ناسا يقولون إن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم تنام عينه ولا ينام قلبه. قال عمرو سمعت عبيد بن عمير يقول رؤيا الأنبياء وحي ثم قال إني أرى في المنام أني أذبحه. Then they said to Amr, the sub-narrator of the hadith, that some people say that the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, his eyes go to sleep but his heart does not go to sleep. Then he said, I heard that the visions of the or the dreams of the prophets are part of revelation because their hearts are awake. So he says, "Inni," he quoted an ayah from the Quran, "Inni ara fil manami anni adbahuk." I see in my dream that I slaughter you. This ayah is talking about Prophet Ibrahim when he was talking to his son Ismail. So we can say that if the Prophet Muhammad goes to deep sleep and he's laying down, that's something special to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in this case. Why? Because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam tanamu aynuhu wa la yanamu qalbu. His eye goes to sleep, but his heart does not go to sleep, as it mentions Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and does remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is one of the special things about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So we're not like him. If you go to deep sleep, then you must wake up and make wudu. باب غسل الوجه باليدين من غرفة واحدة. The hadith says that Ibn Abbas, عن Ibn Abbas أنه توضأ, Ibn Abbas توضأ, he made wudu, فغسل وجهه, he washed his face, ثم أخذ غرفة من ماء, then he took one handful of water, فمضمض بها, he made wudu, واستنشق, and rinsed his mouth with the same one, ثم أخذ غرفة من ماء فجعل بها هكذا, أضافها إلى يده الأخرى فغسل بها وجهه. Then he took a handful of water and washed his face. ثم أخذ غرفة من ماء فغسل بها يده اليمنى. Then he took a handful of water and washed his right hand. ثم أخذ غرفة من ماء فغسل بها يده اليسرى. Then he took one handful of water and washed his left hand. ثم مسح برأسه. Then he wiped over his head. ثم أخذ غرفة من ماء فرش على رجليه اليمنى حتى غسلها. Then he took a handful of water, he put it on his right foot and he washed it. Then he did the same thing with the left one. Then he said, I saw the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ doing that. So the whole point of the hadith is that you can make wudu by washing each part just one time with a handful of water. Also, باب التسمية على كل حال وعند الوقاء. It is part of the wudu also to make Bismillah, to sammi. You say Bismillah before you start. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu says, لو أن أحدكم إذا أتى أهله, when one of you comes to his wife, like to have the sexual intercourse with her, قال بسم الله, he said بسم الله الله, before he starts that he say بسم الله اللهم جنبنا الشيطان وجنب الشيطان ما رزقتنا فقضي بينهما ولد لم يضره شيء. And they have this sexual intercourse resulted in having her pregnant of a kid or a child, then the shaitan will not have control over this child. Why? Because he said بسم الله in the beginning. So that means it's a general thing. When you're doing anything, you should start it with saying Bismillah. So if you're making wudu, if you're eating, if you're starting anything, it is sunnah to say the Bismillah. When you are using the bathroom, say the dua that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-khubthi wal-khaba'ith. Oh Allah, I seek refuge with you from al-khubth and al-khaba'ith. Al-khubth and al-khaba'ith, they say the male jinn and female jinn, or it could be general for all the evil things. باب وضع الماء عند الخلاء. When the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to use the bathroom, sometimes he used the bathroom, and then Abdullah ibn Abbas will put the water for him outside, so that when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is done, he can use it for himself sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then he did it one time. Then the Prophet, when he saw the water near, he said, "Who did this?" They said, "Ibn Abbas." Then after he finished and he got out, he made du'a for him, says, "Allahumma faqihu fi al-din." Oh Allah, give him the understanding of the religion. It's sunnah also when you are using the bathroom that you do not face the qibla, whether you are using the bathroom for number one or two, unless you are in a closed bathroom. Like if you are using the bathroom in open areas like they used to do in the desert in the old times, then you should not face the qibla. But if you are using the bathroom inside your house or inside the your school or anywhere where the bathrooms are roomed and locked and everything, then it should be fine. However, if you are building a new house and you have the option to make the bathroom not to face the qibla, the place where you're going to use the bathroom in the installation, then try to do so. إذا أتى أحدكم الغائط, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, when one of you is using the bathroom, فلا يستقبل القبلة, do not face the قبلة, ولا يوليها ظهره, and do not give your back to the قبلة. So your face is not to the قبلة, your back is not to the قبلة. شرقوا أو غربوا, go either to the right side or the left side, but do not face or give your back to the قبلة. That's also one hadith. We're going to skip some hadith, of course, because we're getting the main ones that this explains how women used to go use a bathroom at the time of the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. They don't have rooms for the bathrooms, so they will go outside. Sometimes also they started to build places for the bathrooms inside the rooms, as you can see. Making istinja with the water, this is something also the Prophet ﷺ did. Istinja is like washing yourself with the water after using the bathroom. And sometimes he used to do istijmar before they do that. Sometimes they do istijmar. Istijmar is like to take a small rock or a small stone, and then you wipe yourself with it, or napkin, and you wipe yourself with it in case if you don't have a lot of water, or in case you want to use it for minimizing the amount of water that you're going to use after that. So you use the napkin first, and then you can use the water after that. Or if you have a lot of water, you can use the water right away. Yes, the Prophet Muhammad forbade the people to use the right hand for washing themselves, because the right hand is used for the clean things and good things. The Prophet Muhammad said, إِذَا شَرِبَ أَحَدُكُمْ فَلَا يَتَنَفَّسْ فِي الْإِنَاءِ. When one of you drinks, do not let him breathe in the cup where he is drinking. Do not breathe, like, do not put your breath there. وَإِذَا أَتَى الْخَلَاءَ فَلَا يَمَسَّ ذَكَرَهُ بِيَمِينِهِ. And when you come to the bathroom, do not touch your private part with your right hand. وَلَا يَتَمَسَّحُ بِيَمِينِهِ. And do not wash it with your right hand. So this is very important. Use the left one, not the right one. This is the one we were talking about, to clean yourself with the stones. As we said before, do not clean yourself with the waste of the animals, the dung of the animals. Because the Prophet Muhammad forbade it and said, هَذَا رِكْسٌ. This is filthy thing. And in another hadith it says that this is the food of the jinn. The jinn asked the Prophet Muhammad one time to give them food, more food, because he have little food. So he made dua, and then he said, every time you bath by bones, the bones will be filled with flesh for you. So we're not supposed to use bones to clean ourselves with. And every time they pass by the waste of the animals, the dung of the animals, when the animals do number two, then this thing will be the food for the animals of the jinn. So we're not supposed to damage it or destroy it by cleaning ourselves with. Of course, we're talking about the people who live in desert and the people who are in open areas, if they're in a trip or something like this. But if you are inside the house, anyway, you don't need to do that at all. Of course, you have the water, so you don't have to worry about that. باب الوضوء مرتين مرتين. The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم washed every part two times, as we said. ثلاثا ثلاثا. Another hadith said that he washed every part three times, but he did not increase it more than this. الاستنثار في الوضوء. من توضأ فليستنثر. Whoever made wudu, let him do استنثار. استنثار is to blow the water out, when you put the water in your nose and you take it out. ومن استجمر فليوتر. And if you clean yourself with the rocks or the stones, then you should do it in an odd number, one time, three times. Another hadith about this thing. Washing the feet. Yes, the Prophet Muhammad one time he warned them, because he saw that some people, when they wash their feet, they don't do it in the best way. So he said, وَيْلُ لِلْأَعْقَابِ مِنَ النَّارِ. He said it twice or three times. Woe, or save your heels from the fire, because they don't wash it in a good way. Al-madmada, making madmada in wudu, that's also part of the wudu, washing the heels again. غسل الرجلين في العلين ولا يمسح على النعلين. Yes, washing the feet. The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, of course, he washes feet, and sometimes he will wipe over the khuf, as we know. But we're gonna come to tayammum to المسح على الخفين later, inshallah. التيمم في الوضوء والغسل. Using the starting with the right. This is one of the sunnah things, and some people consider it, you know, part of the wudu, not just sunnah. That starting with the right side in the wudu, as the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم did. Even in washing the dead body, the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he was talking to a woman, her name is Umu Atiyah, and he said to her, when they were about to wash the body of his daughter, he said, ابدأنا بما يامنها. Start with the right first. ومواضع الوضوء منها. And the wudu parts first. So the right way for doing ghusl is to make wudu for the person who's dead and start with the right side. And even when you're giving him shower or hair, you start with the right side. عائشة قالت كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يعجبه التيمن في تناعله وترجله وطهوره وفي شأنه كله. The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم used to like to start with the right side if he's putting the shoe or if he's combing his hair or if he's making wudu and in all the matters, of course, except for the things that are you know dirty, like using the bathroom, cleaning yourself, you know, stuff like that. باب الماء الذي يغسل به شعر الإنسان. The water that you're gonna use, طبعا of course it should be clean water. We're gonna explain that more inshallah عز وجل, because we have three types of water: الماء الطاهر والماء الطهور والماء النجس. Inshallah عز وجل, this is enough for today, and inshallah we're gonna continue later inshallah. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.